Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today we are going to work on this scroll pattern into 3D, and then it's been using in the jewelry product design and furniture design a lot with this pattern. Are you ready? Let's get started. There are many resources online that you can find by typing scoring patterns. I type it vector, so it will come in the black and white. So we use the command picture to bring in. It can be any size at this point. Let's go ahead to lock it first. And we are going to trace over here. There's a little trick on it that we are going to trace. To trace this outline, you cannot just trace like by this way follow the outline, because it's no way you can creating a 3D like this way in the Rhino. So you have to separate into few parts. So that will be your first part, then you're gonna have a ball, that will be second part, then you're gonna have the third part come over here as a connection, 4, 5, and they are coming over here, and the sixth one is here. So what you need to do is you are going to work on this part like this, this part like this, and remember they will come closer right here. So you want to have it a little bit overlapping. The first one's gonna go all the way and come back and connect it right here with all of them. And so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 is gonna come over here and come back like this, and this will be the 6. So you do have 6 part and bowling together. It's not just gonna done by one part. So let's take a look on this and how we're going to trace it. The first one, I'm going to trace it. You want to get it as close as possible, so we are going to trace something like this. And remember, when you want to coming in to the end, you don't want it to be pointed, so make sure that right here you want to have nice and nice curve coming in. The second one is gonna go from here, and remember right here is quite important, we want to have it overlapping, so we actually want to trace a little bit over than what we need there. And here, make sure it's not too pointed and snapping into the endpoint. You can turn on the control point and then to edit a little bit so it doesn't look like too bumpy. The same thing we're gonna do on this one is we're going to trace. It's gonna go from here and kind of blending in here. You do want them to have it overlapping. It's going to hide it inside, but it's gonna you won't see the gap in between. And then we're going to continue to trace this one. We are going to use the sweep to rail to finish all of them. So what I'm doing here is creating the rail. All right, and then again you can adjust it to make it nice and puffy and fitting into your design. I'm grabbing an online image for the demonstration purpose, but you can always design your own. The third one, look at where I click. This is going to be overlapping, so make sure that it has it all the way to here. And again, this is a bump there, so I might want to get it something like this. And then we are going to continue to trace this one, and again we want this one coming here, and they were overlapping right here. Okay, so the last one, it's gonna be like this. We're going to trace the outline first, and it's coming a big circle over here like this. The second one, remember right here we need to have it overlapping, so we want to make sure that it's inside of this foam and coming over here. And I'm tracing a little bit rough here is because I want to save the time to show you the rest. Then you can adjust it to make it nicer looking and fit into the design. because when we trace, we may not click at the right point, but that's all right. Okay, so the tiny one right here, we have to imagine that it has a powerful overlapping. So the whole point of doing this is you have to see behind the shape, kind of imagine what the 3D look like. All right, so after we've done this, we want to get rid of the background. Let's go ahead to delete it. And for the casting purpose, you do not want to have something really pointed there. So with the next things we're going to do is we're going to give it a little bit radius there to make it a little bit rounded on the tip. Depends on what size you have. I'm using 0.1 at over here, but if your piece is pretty big, you might need to adjust the size as well. Okay, so now let's go ahead to join all of them. The purpose of tracing all this line is going to make a sweep tube. So right now they are joined all together. We need to split them with the point. So it's going to split right at the quadrant or at the middle. And so that will turn into two curves. I have another one that's going to be split with the point. And this one is a closed curve, so I need to split at two spots. One spot is right here, the other spot is right here. Okay, so now it turning into two curves, and this curve as well, I need to split with the point, and let's do right here. Same with this one. Okay. So now everything is done. If you like to practice and you did not find the pattern that you like, I have the curves ready for you. You can use them as a practice. All you need to do is go into the link below. And when you click on the link, you're going to see this subscription form. Just subscribe it, my newsletter, and it will guide you to the file to download. Once you download, you're going to see is those curves. They are already traced and already adjusted, and when you follow the rest of the tutorial, you'll get exactly for what I have here. Okay, so the following step is we need to creating the profile. So I want to come over at the front view, and I'm going to creating something look like this, right? Like a half circle. And then because I want to make it into the solid, so I want to close the button. And this will be my profile. So let's go ahead to join it. Right. Once we have this one, we are going to use the command. It's living under the transform. And then you have the orient to point. Right. So let's go ahead to snapping into the endpoint and the endpoint. Make sure that copy equal yes. And we do want to scale into 3D. And that's zooming the top view. We want to put this cross section right here and also right here and also right here at the end of everything. So one right here. And then for this one, we wanted to create something, this close curve, we want to creating something right in the middle. So something like this. Now let's take a look on the perspective view. All right, so I change all the profile into the red color. It's easier for you to see. So let's go ahead to creating the surface. Let's use the sweep tool. We're going to pick up this one and cross section. And then you will get something like that. Notice that it's folding right here. It doesn't look really good. So let's go ahead to the top view. On the option right here, you do have a choice to add slash, right? So we want to add the slash right here to make it more uniform. And right here and right here. Really quickly, you can see the form look much, much better. And then we click OK. All right, the same thing is going to happen on this one. We are going to sweep two again, rail one, rail two, and this is the cross section. If you do want to make sure that it look nicer, it's look more uniform, you can always add slash. So I'm going to fast forward here, so it will go. You won't feel too bored. All right, so this is what we have. And then I'm just gonna add the sphere with the diameter and snapping into this point to this point. So then I get the sphere there because my profile is half round, so it will match exactly. Okay, so now everything is done. Let's go ahead to cap all of them. This one's a closed curve, so you don't have to cap. All right, now many people may have this problem. So everything now is solid. As you can see on my property, everything that I click is closed solid poly surface. So ideally, we should able to bowling, but let's try this one. Let's say bowling fail. And the reason it is fail, and it will happen to yours, I guarantee, is because you can see from the bottom, everybody is on the same level, so all the seam is 100% aligned. To fix this problem is quite easy. I'm going to pick up this one with the gumball, and I'm just gonna type 0.01. So we're gonna move it up. So the reason we are doing this is because we want to make sure the seam is aligned. Let's do a test. So now we can bowling perfectly. So we are going to bowling this one. It's because the middle one raised up, so the other two is stayed the same place. We're gonna bowling this one, and if it say it's fail, so we are going to move this one up 0.01, and then you are like, so they're no longer being flat. That's okay, because 0.01 is really hard to see. So let's go ahead to bowling all of them. For the bowl, I will need to bowling difference this one out first, because everybody else is flat. So we're gonna do the bowling difference this one out of this one, and then we will bowling unit this two. And again, if it is fail, that's moving up a little bit, and let's do the bowling. Okay, so now this is what we have for the scroll pattern. You can repeat in the pattern to make many different interesting jewelry. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoy. Please like and comment and share my video, so that way I can reach more people. Thank you, and see you next.